recognizing that there are resource constraints, we believe that the government should progressively expand its efforts as resources become available to meet the basic needs of all its citizens. We believe that the government has to acknowledge its responsibilities to meet these basic needs, particularly those of underserved people and places. Priority is to be given to food security, to health and education. The government has to mobilize domestic resources to finance the additional services, and this is in light of the very low percentage of the GNP that Bangladesh takes in taxes. So we're recommending a citizenship tax to finance basic services. The government has to formulate policies for access to these social systems and plan accordingly. In other words, it should have enough personnel, it should invest in structural facilities for instance, health systems, and it should ensure implementation, particularly for excluded groups, by enforcing and enforcing the monitoring of their performance, making sure that doctors are where they're supposed to be and teachers are where they're supposed to be. We also think as part of its obligation, the government should provide for the legal requirements and ensure that the private sector is also contributing to the social protections of its employees, because there is no provision for employers to contribute to the social insurance of their employees. In terms of civil society, we feel that civil society has to hold the government accountable to ensure food security, basic health, and education for all. That civil society should coordinate its efforts in order to raise awareness among citizens to their basic rights, to have their basic needs fulfilled. It should hold government actors and officials accountable for fulfilling their obligations at all the different levels of reform. It should work with the media for advocacy work to put pressure on government to acknowledge its obligations. And it should try and create a coalition of interested actors and relevant actors to keep the pressure up for government to fulfill its obligations. And as far as the international community is concerned, we would like it to fulfill its own ODA obligations, which is often plain to do, and it should coordinate its efforts amongst within the community and work with government and civil society to operationalize the commitment to meeting the basic needs of all citizens of Bangladesh, with a particular focus on those with the weakest political voice.
The role of these different groups, so that each is dependent on one. And because we wanted to see that we put this marginalized community or the citizens at the center, and how this group can be involved by Bangladeshi civil society, which can have an interlinked relationship with the international civil society, government of Bangladesh, and development partners. There's like a multi-linked relationship. So if we start at that level, that in terms of Bangladeshi civil society, when we talk about political participation, we talk about a lot of the mobilization that needs to happen at the very grassroots level in terms of making awareness. So we're talking about at the individual level, more active and active participation and local awareness rising on rights for individual citizens. So that means first, they need to be aware of what their rights are, and then they need to be aware have the tools to articulate or demand what they demand their rights as well. So that would mean for the national level civil society, you know, Bangladesh to have a more of active role in advocacy of those rights, and in terms of larger and larger visibility for the marginalized group in the national framework, whether it's however way they do it, whether it's with policy making, some sort of accountability from the part of the NGOs out there. So there is a recommendation of establishing a GNCC, this Government NGO Coordination Committee, which will be used for ensuring transparent and accountable functioning of NGOs.
To ensure access to justice, particularly for marginalized communities. By that we mean strengthen the registrar's office, credible criteria of appointment for judges, prevent interference by the executive, and address impunity. So the second point that we could recommend is, that the international community should recommend and engage that you look to the government of Bangladesh is to speed up the process for the reform of the police, to ensure due process of law, and to ensure free methods of investigation, and ensure greater gender sensitivity and responsiveness to marginalized communities. And the third point, to strengthen initiatives on prison reform. So this is the third point of the first point. The second point, still which is aligning with the international community, so they should provide institutional support, by that means training, financial support, capacity building, and to the marginalized communities, awareness raising, partnering with civil societies, with society groups in Bangladesh, strengthening cooperation between the national legal aid organization and civil society legal services. So the government has legal aid in the region and also civil societies, but they are not developed all around the country. So it would be good to strengthen these links and to spread them in all around the country. Then for the international civil society, we became a little bit lazy. So we just wrote a little paragraph. So the international civil society should monitor and campaign to ensure the recommendation and above. So we expect from the committee to rewrite all the recommendations. It's only copy-paste. And the civil society in Bangladesh, should monitor, campaign, and engage in advocacy to realize the recommendation made above. And to extend their services to engage in advocacy for the realization of the rights of marginalized communities.
That was the context of our discussions, and we discussed for now understanding the issues properly, because so many of the group members, you know, some of them really exposed to the issues, but some of them are not really concerned. So we discussed in our thinking that, you know, what is the issues exactly. We have some photographs, we showed that, and all these understanding the issues properly. Then we discussed a lot. There is a debate on this. And, you know, constitutionally, it is a fundamental right, definitely. Constitution says that, you know, there is no discrimination based on caste,